Dr. Jo Robinson is the head of suicide prevention research at Orygen, and she says authorities need to examine how they tackle this issue.
We're focusing our efforts in the wrong place. Mm. We need a service system that can better respond to young people when they present with risk. Unfortunately, we have large numbers of young people turned away from services every year who are presenting with high rates of depression, high rates of self-harm and suicide risk.
Is that a funding issue?
I think there's very much a funding issue and there's a capacity issue. Yeah. The population is growing, certainly in the areas that we're working in. We're on major growth corridors, but we're not seeing increased investment into those services in those particular areas. What we're seeing are young people who are potentially not unwell enough to meet criteria to get into services, right. Even services like Headspace. So what we're seeing are people sitting on waiting lists. They might not quite be sick enough yet, but they remain at risk of suicide. Young people find technology and social media platforms a very acceptable source of help. So young people like to use those platforms. They're available 24 hours a day. They can access them from the privacy of their own homes. But they've not really found their way into suicide prevention activity going forward, and we really need to see that change.
And if you or someone you know is experiencing distress, please contact Lifeline. The number is 13 11 14. Or if you need information or support, you can also contact Beyond Blue. There's the number there, 1300 22 46 46.